Thailand's political turmoil isn't something new, but Standard & Poor's says should it go on any longer, it will look into downgrading its credit rating. Mere hiccup, says Thailand's new caretaker prime minister and commerce minister.
I would say that this is a temporary setback of this, the investors' confidence and also the slowdown of the domestic economy. But anyhow, I believe in Thailand's economic fundamentals. We run the monetary and fiscal discipline accordingly.
Protests, travel restrictions, and unpredictable outbreaks of violence have had an impact on the economy. And all this has an impact on customers walking through the door. But for some international businesses like Harley Davidson, who've been in Thailand for a decade, while the political instability is a concern, it's something they've learned to work around.
We already have in place since the beginning ways to do business with customers remotely. Either it could be online or it could be delivery of bikes or pickup services. All these kinds of convenience factors that we've already built into the business.
Countries like the U.S. are watching what happens in Thailand closely. U.S. businesses have been operating in the country for 180 years. Total trade between the two countries in 2013 was around $38 billion worth. While well-established businesses have learned to weather the storm, it's those trying to enter the market that are being impacted the most.
Where the opportunity lost comes in is for new investors. You know, if this situation drags on, American businesses are looking at Southeast Asia, but it's competitive. And they'll want to pick a place where they feel confident of the politics, confident that there's a good environment to come into. So if this drags on, there may be opportunities lost as American investors look at other countries in the region.
The political stalemate has led to investment interruption and delay. There are at least 400 large-scale projects worth around $20 billion awaiting approval by the Board of Investment. Its hands have been tied, while Thailand is dragged from one unstable government setup to another. The new caretaker government, though, is promising to clear the backlog within 3 to 4 months.
We want to become the most attractive investment locations for all the investors, especially when we have this ASEAN coming up next year. We should be ready by then.
An optimistic forecast, and for that, Thailand will have to find a stable and sustainable political solution to ensure its strong economic fundamentals remain on solid ground. Saima Mohsin, CNN, Bangkok, Thailand.